Let's get it. As one, Crookshank, your one and only Move Swiftly speaker, checking in for a daily Move Swiftly thought, giving you a perspective on teamwork that you will not get anywhere else. Good day today, good day today. Long run Tuesday, did 10 miles. It's good to feel all right after a 10-mile run. You know, normally last week I knocked out 16, and knees been bothering me a little bit this morning, so made the business decisions to cut it at 10 miles, and it feels good to know that I can say only 10 miles, because the 10 miles did not feel really that bad. You still got a lot left in the tank. However, making the business decision to get my knee right and keep everything ready to go for this marathon coming. I don't know when I'm gonna do it. In fact, I'm more so leaning towards just doing one individually, seeing how it turned out last year, instead of actually registering for one. I am kind of leaning in the direction of knocking out one just on my own, when the mood is right, when the feeling's right, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Go get it done, right? All right, so as far as today's Move Swiftly thought, you already know, regular consumers, you already know Tuesday, top five Tuesday, top five Tuesday. Every single Tuesday, count down the top five of something, and it's all based on what happened to me throughout the previous 7 days, you know, just what I'm feeling at the time. Somebody may have said something to me, and, you know, so there may be some current event going on, something just kind of flipped a switch to say, all right, that's the top five Tuesday for this week. So I'll just explain to you. I was at another Duffy's. I was actually, this past Saturday, I went to the FAU game, FAU versus North Texas. So drove out to the Duffy's out in that Boca area. And it was a Duffy's that I have not been to yet. And I was watching a lot of Big Ten football. I was watching a lot of college football, not just Big Ten, but, you know, I was, like I was telling you guys, I believe it was Sunday morning. I was telling you guys how, you know, I was kind of leaning into the Big Ten game, seeing that I'm a Michigan fan, right? And it just so happened that next to me, there was this guy whose affiliate, his wife works at Michigan State, and he's actually from Michigan. So I was wearing my Michigan hat, and we ended up kind of having a dialogue and sparking up a conversation on football, politics, the whole thing. You know how it is in these sports parts. You know, football and politics come up very, very frequently. So, you know, we're just chatting a little bit, and I was telling him about a lot of the work I got out there, you know, my YouTube channel and the socials and the work that I do. And he was telling me how he keeps up with quite a few people, and he asked me if I'm heavy on X, which is formerly known as Twitter. And I do have an X account, however, I never check it. Like, literally very rarely do I actually check it. I have it to where all my posts come out on a scheduler, and it comes out everyone, all the platforms and all that kind of stuff. So, you know, I don't really consume it as much. I don't, you know, the posts do come out, but I never actually check the feedback or anything like that. And he was someone that's really heavy on X, seeing that Elon Musk bought it, and Elon Musk has made some adjustments. I'm guessing he made some adjustments to the platform to where people can see real time what's really happening and not all the edited interviews and all that kind of stuff. All right. So anyway, I said that's a long way of me saying, hey, today's top five is my top five social media platforms. But the reason I wanted to give you that explanation is because I want you guys to understand the importance of posting on every single platform, and posting is on as many platforms as possible. I'm not telling you to check it every 2 seconds. I'm telling you to make sure everything is being posted, everything is being out there, just in case, you know, someone may be heavy on X versus being heavy on Instagram, all that kind of stuff, right? So in regards to me, in regards to my top five social platforms, number one easily is Google. All right, Google is the number one, in my opinion, should be everybody's number one, but it's not. But again, Google for me is very important. I'm constantly Googling my name to make sure certain things are being put out there. And, you know, because there's no scrubbing a Google, you know, Google is the most powerful search engine out there. So when people look you up, there has to be some substance there. There has to be some material out there that's going to make it so they're able to validate the things that you tell them via phone call, via Zoom, whatever it is, and all that kind of stuff. So Google's number one. Next one is YouTube. As you can see, it's multiple posts, multiple videos are coming out every single day. Number three is Medium, medium.com. Medium.com is where I'm able to articulate my words in the written format and write it out and make sure everything is spell checked and look it over and all that kind of stuff. Number four and five are Instagram and Facebook, Facebook and Instagram, either one, because when I post on one, the other one gets the same, you know, gets the same exact post, and I'm able to just simply share and they post together because Facebook actually bought Instagram, all right? And as you can tell, my list is more so about being synonymous with the next one. So number one, again, Google and YouTube. Google bought YouTube, so they're in cohesive. They work together. Their search engines are together. Medium, the written word. Myself as an author, myself as a writer, constantly getting my thoughts out in the written format so I'm able to articulate myself via video. And then the social platforms, but for me personally, would be Instagram and Facebook, because Facebook bought Instagram, and you know, if I post on one, the other one goes there, so it lessens the amount of time that I have to waste posting on stuff and all that kind of stuff, right? Now, the one that is should be on this list too, LinkedIn. LinkedIn should be on the list as well. And it deserves an actual mention. It's important that there's a reason that LinkedIn's actually on the thumbnail of this, but LinkedIn does deserve a mention, because when it comes to the actual work that I do, when it comes to innovative teamwork and teaching business owners how to innovate, LinkedIn is a powerful tool search engine for me as well. So they do make the list in regard. I didn't put them in the top five per se, but they're definitely, like, you know, deserve an honorable mention in this as well. All right. All that being said, main website, we'll get about all those social platforms for a second. And the main website you need to be checking out to dive deeper into all my work, it's makeyamove.com. That's makeyamove.com. One stop shop for your teamwork and your self-development needs. As one Crookshank, your one and only Move Swiftly speaker, checking out. You guys continue to move swiftly. We will talk more soon.